Hello, I'm Simon Whistler. You're watching TopTenzNet, and in the video today, we're continuing our series on crazy what-if scenarios. Have you ever thought about what the world would be like if it was a cube? Or what about if we chose to live underwater? Or what if every nuclear bomb in the world went off? Well, these are just a few of the crazy scenarios in our latest installment of Top 10 Crazy What-If Scenarios. Number 10. What would happen if all of the mosquitoes suddenly died out? In many cases, losing a species is a bad thing for an ecosystem because ecosystems are structured like pyramids. If you take out a species on the low end of the food chain like frogs, then everything that frogs eat will have their population explode. On the other hand, animals that eat frogs, they're going to die off because there isn't enough food to sustain their population. So what would happen if we decided to kill off all the mosquitoes? Mosquitoes are not only annoying pests, but they are disease carriers. To name just a few of the more serious diseases they transmit, we've got malaria, West Nile virus, elephantiasis, dengue fever, and yellow fever. On the other hand, they are part of the food chain because their larvae is eaten by frogs and fish. So would it be that bad if we killed them all off? Well, Catherine Rocken, an entomologist at the University of Manitoba, says not a whole lot would change. In the long run, the ecosystems will bounce back because no animals or insects are completely mosquito-dependent, which is great news. So let's go and just kill all the mosquitoes, shall we? Number 9. What would happen if you lived in water? Maybe life on land, maybe it's become too much for you and you think, screw it, I'm gonna go live in a giant tank of water. I mean, who hasn't had that thought on occasion? But the question now becomes, well, would that be a viable way to live? Well, according to the website Dig, which interviewed a dermatologist, you would notice problems within a day or two. Between the top layer of skin, which is called the epidermis, and the middle layer of skin, which is the dermis, bubbles will begin to form. These bubbles will burst, and your skin will begin to peel away. This is actually what happened to David Blaine when he spent 7 days in a tank of water. When your skin peels, it will expose the dermis, which isn't meant to be exposed, and it definitely shouldn't be exposed to the water that you've been living and defecating in. You'll probably develop an infection, and unless you get help, you will die. Number 8. What would happen if the Yellowstone supervolcano exploded? In the Wyoming section of the Yellowstone National Park, there is a supervolcano. The last time it erupted was 174,000 years ago. But what would happen if it erupted again? Of course, lava is going to ooze out, but that's not going to be the biggest concern unless you happen to be in the immediate area. Instead, ash will be scattered over 500 miles, and it will be 4 inches thick when it settles on nearby land. The American Midwest and Pacific Northwest would be the hardest hit. Agriculture in the area would be utterly devastated, and rivers would be clogged with gray muck. Gases like sulfur dioxide will be spewed into the air, and not only will this make everything smell terrible, but the gas and the ash will block sunlight from getting to Earth. This is going to cool a part of the planet. This cooling would last for a decade, and it would dramatically alter the weather. But there are two pieces of good news in this what-if scenario. The first is that this is very unlikely to happen anytime soon, and the second is that it won't be a death blow for humans. Our ancestors experienced supervolcano eruptions, and they survived, so there is no reason to believe humanity wouldn't survive this one as well. Number 7. What would happen if you exploded a nuclear bomb in the deepest part of the ocean? If you detonate a nuclear bomb near the surface of the water, it's quite an impressive show because thousands of gallons of water shoot up into the air. But what happens when a nuclear bomb is exploded 6 miles underwater? In their What If web series webcomic, XKCD answers the question of what would happen if someone exploded a large bomb in the Mariana Trench. The Mariana Trench is found in the Western Pacific and is the deepest part of the ocean. The deepest known measurement is a remarkable 36,070 feet. This explosion in the deepest part of the ocean would be nothing like what would happen if you detonated it near the surface. Instead, it will create a bubble that is about 0.6 miles across, and then the pressure will cause it to collapse to its minimal size. Then it will expand again, and it will do this 3 or 4 more times. After that, not a lot is going to be left except for some debris and some warm water, and also, presumably, a lot of annoyed fish who suddenly find themselves with superpowers. Number 6. What if the world was a cube? All large masses in the universe are spheres, and this includes Earth. But what would happen if the Earth was a cube? All the water and the atmosphere would be drawn to where the gravity is strongest, and that will be at the center of each face of the cube. In the center of each face, there will be a large ocean. There is also a good chance that each face could have very different ecosystems. The edges and the corners of the Earth would be rocky, with very little atmosphere. However, this cube, it wouldn't last very long. Eventually, it would start to round out until it was a sphere, just like the rest of the massive objects in the universe. Number 5. What if the world was flat? No matter what some crazy people might say, the world is absolutely not flat. But what if it was flat? What if the Earth was actually pancake-shaped? Gizmodo asked a few experts, and, well, the news is not good. Gravity would be an immediate problem. At the center of the flat Earth, gravity would be less than it is now, and it would be weaker around the edges of the flat Earth. Without gravity, we wouldn't have an atmosphere, so Earth simply wouldn't be possible. We also wouldn't have a magnetic field, and cosmic rays would prevent any life from forming. However, if by some miracle we did manage to survive on such an Earth, well, everyone would see the same stars all the time, and we also wouldn't be able to see the curvature of the Earth. Number 4. What would happen if the Earth stopped spinning? Currently, the Earth spins at about 1,000 miles per hour, but what would happen if it suddenly stopped spinning? There are two possible ways that this could happen. The first is that it stops spinning immediately. If that happens, everything that isn't bedrock would fly off the Earth and out into the atmosphere, which would be a pretty wild ride. The other way, of course, is a gradual slowdown. If the Earth stopped spinning over billions of years, we wouldn't be thrown off the planet. The Earth would be a much different place, though. Days and nights would be 6 months long, meaning a day would be as long as a year. The Earth's spin creates centrifugal force at the equator, and this creates a bulge. This bulge keeps all the oceans where they are. Now, if the Earth stops spinning, all the oceans would go to the top and to the bottom of the Earth, leaving a belt of land around the planet. Humans may be able to survive for a short time on thin strips of the Earth, but without the world rotating, the electric field that protects us from cosmic rays would fade. This would cause Earth's atmosphere to be ripped away by the sun's natural wind, and without atmosphere, well, we wouldn't survive for very long. Number 3. What would happen if the moon exploded? On the dark side of the moon, an advanced alien race drills deep into the moon and implants a mind-bogglingly powerful explosive. They then take off, and when they are a safe distance away, they detonate the explosive, and the moon explodes into several large pieces and millions of smaller pieces. So now the big questions become, well, what would happen to us here on Earth, and why are aliens jerks? Well, we can't answer that second question, but we can take a stab at the first. If you're one of the 17 people who saw the 2002 version of the time machine, you know it's not good. First, the pieces would break up and form a torus, which is a donut-like ring around the Earth. This would make it very difficult for us to leave the Earth, which is going to be bad news because we're going to want to leave if we want to survive. First, the small flaming pieces, they're going to rain down on the Earth for the next 5,000 to 10,000 years. It will eventually get so hot that the oceans will evaporate, so it's a slightly bigger disaster than the time machine. The good news is that despite what those aliens might try, it is nearly impossible to blow up the moon. We just hope that no rogue planets smash into it. Number 2. What would happen if every nuclear device exploded? Unfortunately, in the summer and fall of 2017, a legitimate fear for some people was the outbreak of nuclear war. One question that inevitably arises when people think about nuclear war is what would happen if all the nuclear weapons in the world went off? IFL Science took a look at this question, and surprise, surprise, things, they are not looking good. According to the Federation of American Scientists, there are around 14,900 nuclear weapons in the world. A vast majority of them are in the possession of Russia and the United States. Also, there are varying levels of power when it comes to nuclear weapons. Russia and the US have thermonuclear weapons, while a country like North Korea has fission-style. One of the most powerful American nuclear weapons is B-83. It's as powerful as 79 little boy atomic bombs. That's the one dropped on Hiroshima, by the way. One bomb would cause a fireball that is 2.2 square miles. All buildings within a 6.5 square mile radius would be flattened. It would burn everyone within 162 miles to the point where their nerve endings will burn off. 50 to 90% of people within 8 square miles will die of radiation sickness. IFL Science says that if the average device possessed by Russia and the United States is similar to a B-83, debris and they were spread out evenly and hit land, it would be utterly devastating. It will turn 90,000 square miles, which is about the size of 295 New York cities, to dust. A fireball will also form and it will grow to the size of 31,000 square miles. This is about the size of 3,700 Londons. Everyone who is in that area would be totally vaporized. Ah, yes, and then we move on to the fallout. It will be spread out over 110,000 miles. If the wind is blowing and it gets into the lower atmosphere, it could spread even farther. For those people who weren't wiped out by the nuclear blasts, or survived the fireball, or doesn't die from radiation exposure, then they're going to have to deal with a brutal nuclear winter. All the destruction on Earth would send up ash, dust, and soot into the air. This would stop solar radiation from reaching Earth for years, possibly even centuries. During this time, the Earth will be dark and without sunlight, and plant life will die off. Most animals, including humans, will die off a short time later. The real hope is that if this does happen, you're one of the people who's vaporized, because then there's only going to be a second of pain and then nothing. Number 1. What would happen if Earth lost oxygen for 5 seconds? Clearly, oxygen is pretty important to life here on Earth, but do you know exactly how important it is? For example, what would happen if we lost all the oxygen in the world for 5 seconds? You're probably thinking, well, not too much. After all, you can probably hold your breath for at least 5 seconds, so it's not likely you're going to suffocate. But the reality is that it's actually much, much worse than that. BuzzFeed took a short break from telling you which Friends character you should eat taco salad with to explain that if oxygen went away during the day, the sky would turn dark because sunlight reflects off oxygen particles. Untreated metal would also instantly weld together because a layer of oxidation is what keeps metals from doing that. However, we probably wouldn't have time to notice the metal welding together or the sky turning dark because we'd have much bigger problems. Notably, the Earth's crust is 45% oxygen. Without oxygen, it would crumble. Buildings would also be turned to dust because, you guessed it, oxygen is an important element in concrete. As for humans, you would immediately get a sunburn because oxygen molecules help protect us from UV light. Everyone's eardrums would also blow out because we'd lose too much air pressure. But the reality is we probably wouldn't notice most of these things because the human body is 60% water, and a major component of water is, of course, oxygen. Without oxygen, every single living cell would simply be hydrogen gas. Finally, the oceans, they'd evaporate, and all the hydrogen, which was once you and every living cell on Earth, would float away into the sky. So basically, it would suck even more than the time machine. So I really hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below and don't forget to subscribe. Also, if you're looking for something else to watch, I've got a new channel. It's called Biographics, where we look at biographies of famous and important people from history and in the present day as well. Loads of people over there. Do check out what we're up to on that channel and subscribe if you like it. You'll find a link to it in the description below. And as always, thank you for watching.